Starting. Let me share the screen. Just a minute.
Hi.
Hello, hello. Mute yourself. Yes. Okay. So we're discussing about the classification of plant kingdom as per the system proposed by scientist Eichler. Or Eichler, it is also pronounced as Eichler in Germany. It is pronounced as Eichler in UK and US. So he classified all the plants of the world into two types, cryptogams and phanerogams. Cryptogamy or phanerogamy. Cryptogamy is the name of the taxon, you see. And all those plants which belong to this group, cryptogamy, are called as cryptogams. Phanerogamy is the name of group. Scientific name is phanerogamy. And phanerogams are all plants are commonly called as phanerogams, which belong to this group, phanerogamy. Cryptogamy, phanerogam. Cryptogams and phanerogams. Now, do you know what are cryptogams and what are phanerogams? So these words, these terms are the combination of two Greek words. You can see here. This is a combination of two words. Cryptogams is a combination of two words, cryptos and gamos. Cryptos means hidden, concealed, not visible. Gamos means reproductive parts or marriage. Similarly, phanerogams or phanerogamy is a combination of two words, phaneros and gamos. Phaneros means visible. Gamos means reproductive parts or marriage. Now, what are reproductive parts? You can imagine in case of higher plants, the reproductive part, which is visible, you can see here, visible to the naked eye. We can see that reproductive part, which is present on the plant body, and that visible reproductive part is called as the flower. So here, those plants in which the reproductive part is visible in the form of flower are called as phanerogams. Phanerogamy. So these plants are also called as flowering plants. Here, the reproductive part is not visible because it is hidden, it is concealed. It is not flower, but it is something else, and that is not visible to the naked eye. So these plants are called as non-flowering plants. And you know, when flower is present, what happens? The flower after fertilization is converted into fruit, and inside that, seeds are present. So when flower is present, seeds are present. So these plants are also called as seed producing plants, seed bearing plants, flowering plants or seed plants. They are called as phanerogams. Whereas non-flowering plants or seedless plants are known as cryptogams. Okay. Now as these plants, phanerogams, they produce seeds, they are also called as spermatophyta. Because sperma is again a Greek word which means seed, and phyton is another Greek word which means plant. So spermatophyta are seed plants, these plants, phanerogams. Phanerogams are also called as spermatophyta, seed plants, because they produce seeds. They bear flowers. These are flowering plants, seed producing plants, whereas cryptogams are non-flowering plants or seedless plants. Okay. Now we'll discuss about what are cryptogams and what are phanerogams in detail. Now cryptogams, you know, non-flowering plants or seedless plants, they are of two types. As per Eichler, they can be divided into two types, lower cryptogams and higher cryptogams. These words, lower and higher, signifies the characters, characteristics. If the characters are lower, primitive in the course of when we discuss the concept of evolution, when the characters are primitive, because these plants are developed first in the evolution, therefore these characters can be called as lower characters. So those plants which bear these lower characters are called as lower cryptogams, primitive characters. Whereas those plants which have some advanced characters, evolved characters, higher characters are called as higher cryptogams. Now, what these lower characters and higher characters are? There are three important characters. The first one is plant body, nature of plant body. Second one is the nature of sex organs or reproductive organs. And third one is the nature of embryo. You can see here. Vegetative plant body, sex organs and embryo. You see, when or if the plant body, if the vegetative plant body of the plant is undifferentiated, if the plant body is undifferentiated, that means it is not differentiated. And such an undifferentiated mass of cells, you know, undifferentiated mass of cells in vitro is, in case of tissue culture, undifferentiated mass of cells is called as callus. So here in vivo, in real plant body, such an undifferentiated mass of cells is known as thallus. So here the plant body is undifferentiated. It is called as the thallus. The plant body is undifferentiated means it is not differentiated into the organs like root, stem and leaves. Such a plant body is called as undifferentiated plant body. So such a plant body is called as the thallus. The plant body is called as thallus means it is without root, stem and leaves. Such an undifferentiated plant body or thallus is the characteristic feature of those plants which belong to lower cryptogams. So that is the first character. The second character is regarding the sex organs. The sex organs are reproductive organs like male reproductive structure, female reproductive structure in these plants are always unicellular, single cell. Single cell is male sex organ, single cell is female sex organ, and these single cells produce single gametes. Like male sex organ produces male gametes, female sex organ produces female gametes. So these sex organs are always unicellular, single cell in lower cryptogams. Whereas the embryo in lower cryptogams is always absent. The embryo stage is always absent in lower cryptogams. That means the after fertilization of male gamete and female gamete, single cell is formed, diploid structure is formed, and that is known as the zygote. Now this zygote directly gives rise to new plant body without formation of embryo. Zygote is a unicellular cell, diploid cell, and it gives rise to undifferentiated plant body, thallus, without formation of embryo. So these are three important characters. Plant body, undifferentiated, called as the thallus. Sex organs are always unicellular, and embryo stage is absent in the life cycle of these plants called as lower cryptogams. Now, what are the characters belonging to higher cryptogams? Same characters. The vegetative plant body, sex organs, and embryo. Here, the vegetative plant body is either slightly differentiated or it is totally differentiated into the organs like root, stem, and leaves. In some plants, the plant body is differentiated into root-like, stem-like, leaf-like structure, or in some other plants, plant body is differentiated into true root, stem, and leaves. That means in these plants, root, stem, and leaves are present. These are higher cryptogams. Okay, in lower cryptogams, root, stem, and leaves are absent. The plant body is called like the thallus. Here, the plant body may be thalloid or it is differentiated into the structures like root, stem, and leaves. The second character here is sex organs. Sex organs are always multicellular. Here in this case, sex organs are always unicellular, single cell. Here, sex organs are multicellular. Many cells come together to form male sex organ. Similarly, many cells come together to form female sex organs. And when there are many cells, the situation is like this. There is a multiple or multi-layer of central region of cells, fertile cells, which form sex cells, and these are surrounded by a peripheral layer of sterile cells. So here sex organs are multicellular with a sterile layer of jacket cells. The peripheral layer, which is sterile layer, serves the function of protection of these sex organs. So here sex organs are always unicellular. Here sex organs are multicellular with a sterile layer of jacket cells. So that is the character of higher cryptogams. And here embryo stage is always present in the life cycle. That means zygote, which is unicellular diploid cell, it divides, redivides, and it produces a multicellular diploid structure, undifferentiated structure that is known as embryo. And this embryo is always present inside the female sex organ. Their development takes, its development takes place in the female sex organ, and then it gives rise to, this embryo gives rise to new plant body. Here in this case, embryo stage is always absent. Zygote directly gives rise to the plant body called as the thallus. Here embryo gives rise to the plant body, which is slightly differentiated. So these are the distinguishing characters between lower cryptogams and higher cryptogams. Now, as the vegetative plant body in lower cryptogams is called as the thallus, which is undifferentiated plant body, these plants are also called as thallophyta. Thallo means thallus, phyta means plant. Thallus bearing plants, thallophyta. And which are these plants, thallophyta? These are algae, fungi, and lichens. You know this example, Spirogyra, famous example of algae. Mucor agaricus is famous example of fungi. We are going to discuss these classes in much detail in the later classes. And lichens, a combination of algae and fungi, a symbiotic association called as lichens, for example, Palmalia. These are the examples. So lower cryptogams are also called as thallophyta, whereas higher cryptogams, where plant body is differentiated, they're also called as cormophyta. Opposite to thallophyta, where plant body is called as the thallus, here the differentiated plant body is called as cormophyta, or they are also called as embryophyta, because here embryo stage is always present in the life cycle. Now all plants are cannot be classified together here, because embryophyta consist of some higher plants also, but for the sake of our convenience, for distinguishing, I have given the word embryophyta here, because these plants consist of embryo stage in the life cycle, and they are also called as cormophyta. Lower cryptogams are called as thallophyta. Higher cryptogams are called as cormophyta or embryophyta. You may not remember this. You just remember higher cryptogams are the plants which show these characters, and these higher cryptogams are two types: bryophyta, moss plant, mosses are the common examples, and pteridophyta, ferns. You are familiar with very common examples of ferns in these plants. There are many examples, but the most common one are mosses belonging to bryophyta and ferns belonging to pteridophyta. Okay. Next group is phanerogams, flowering plants, seed producing plants, also called as spermatophyta. Now in these plants, flower is present, and these plants are of two types: gymnosperm or gymnospermy and angiosperms or angiospermy. Now again, these terms are derived from the combination of Greek words like gymnos means naked, sperma means seeds, angion means vessel, sperma means seeds. Vessel means case. A type of protective covering is called as vessel or case. So here in those plants in which seeds are present in the vessel, seeds are protected in a case, and that case is called as the fruit. That means those plants in which seeds are present in the fruit are called as angiosperms, whereas those plants in which seeds are not present in the fruit, they are called as gymnosperms. Are you getting? Seeds are present here in fruit. Why seeds are present in the fruit? Because before fertilization, in these plants, ovules are present in the ovary, whereas in these cases, in gymnosperms, ovary is absent. So ovules are directly exposed. They are not present inside the ovary. So after fertilization, ovules get converted into seeds. But as there is no ovary, there is no fruit formation. So gymnosperms are the plants which are having flower, not actual flower. They are either in the case of strobilus or cone. And these flowers consist of ovules directly exposed on them, and these ovules form seeds. So there is no fruit formation. And here, in this case, there is formation of fruit. So angiosperms are also called as fruit plants, whereas gymnosperms are called as fruitless plants, without fruits. And therefore, seeds become naked. Seeds become open. Are you getting? Now, these are some of the examples of angiosperms: pea, beans, sunflower, and wheat, rice, jowar. These are the examples of higher plants called as angiosperms: cycas, pinus, neatum. There are many examples which belong to gymnosperms. Now here, why I have written two examples separately? Because you must be knowing that the first one, the former one, are the examples of a group of plants of angiosperms called as dicots, dicotyledons, whereas wheat, rice, jowar, bajri are the examples of monocots. Okay, so this is the outline classification of plant kingdom. All plants of the world can be either belonging to cryptogams or phanerogams. Cryptogams are non-flowering plants, seedless plants. Phanerogams are flowering plants, seed producing plants. So they are also called as spermatophyta. They are of two types: gymnosperms, open seeded plants or naked seeded plants, and angiosperms, closed seeded plants, which are of two types: dicots and monocots. This entire classification is based on the evolution concept. Here dicots are kept first and monocots are placed later. That means dicots are more primitive. They came first during the course of evolution, and monocots are the most advanced group of plants which came very late in the course of evolution of the plant kingdom. Whereas algae are the most primitive, very simple plants, primitive plants of the entire plant kingdom. Therefore, they are kept first. So cryptogams, non-flowering plants or seedless plants, they are of two types: lower cryptogams, also called as thallophyta, and higher cryptogams, also called as cormophyta. Lower cryptogams are of different types, like algae, fungi, the main types. Lichen is a combination of algae and fungi, but you can consider it as a separate class also of lower cryptogams. Algae, fungi, lichens, these are lower cryptogams, thallophytes, belonging to cryptogams. Whereas bryophyta, pteridophyta, these are belonging to higher cryptogams. We are going to discuss these plants in much detail, higher cryptogams or cormophyta. And this is the outline classification of plant kingdom. So all these, you have seen cryptogams, phanerogams, gymnosperms, angiosperms. These are the technical terms which are derived from the Greek words. They can be derived from Greek language or Latin language, which are not used today. And these languages are self-sufficient to give the meaning of the words. Like in case of our nation or our country, the Sanskrit language is used for proposing different terminologies for these technical terms, scientific terms. So accordingly, so here that classification is given. This is not in your syllabus as such. This is not the medium of instruction, because this is, you can see, this is a vernacular classification, Marathi classification or Sanskrit classification, Vanaspati. Just a minute. You can see here, cryptogams called as apushpa. Pushpa means flower, a means absent. Flower is absent, non-flowering plants, apushpa. You are getting cryptogams, sapushpa, flowering plants in which flower is present. And as flower is present, beej also present, seeds are present. So these are called as sabij or only beeji vanaspati, and these are abiji, non-seedless plants. Kayak vanaspati means thallophyta. Kaya means the body, thallophyta, thallus-like plant body. So shaiwal, kavak, and shaiwak. Shaiwal for algae, kavak for fungi, shaiwak for lichens. And these are skandavat vanaspati, cormophytes, which are shaiwali means bryophytes, neche, vargi means pteridophytes. So here sapushpa, biji vanaspati, they are called as avrutta biji, means in which the bij or seed is avrutta, means enclosed in the fruit. And here these are prakat bij or anavrutta bij. So I have devised very simple words here. Safala vanaspati and afala vanaspati. Safala means with fruit, those plants in which fruit is present. So these are angiosperms, and these are afala, means those plants in which fruit is absent, gymnosperms. So these can also be called as wiffle, because they have become wiffled, non-successful in the course of evolution. Gymnosperms, they are now getting vanished. Whereas angiosperms is the most successful group of plant kingdom. So it can be called as suffle, because it has fruit and it is also successful in the course of evolution. It is of two types, dwidal, dicot, and ekdal, means monocot. So you can, for the purpose of your understanding, I have given this. Otherwise, you have to remember this classification, outline classification of plant kingdom given by scientist Eichler based on the concept of evolution. So here is a scientist, Eichler, Photocortus is given, who classified the entire plant kingdom. These are some of the references which I used. Someone has made one line here, annotations are given. there. You should not do this like this. It is looking very bad, you know. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, any query, then you can ask me. You can unmute yourself, or you can also write in the chat box. Do you have any questions? Yes, Pathare. Do you have any question? Any problem in national system of classification of plant kingdom? I'm not getting your voice. You can write in the chat box. No question? Okay. If you have any, then you can also write in our WhatsApp group, or you can also mail me. I have given in the very start my email ID I have provided. You can ask me on email, you can email me, or you can directly ask in our WhatsApp group, or you can privately send questions to my WhatsApp number. You are free. Questions are always welcome. I am very happy to answer your queries, your difficulties, your questions. Okay, no questions now at the moment? No question there?
No, sir.
Okay. So shall I close the meeting now?
Okay.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you all. Have a good day. Thank you.